More combos. Now what? Not it. Perfect shot. Let's put him down.
Let night fall. Lights off. See the entry of this beep, but none of pyramids six beep. I be hella open time of pyramid is Giza. This please cause I'm too fool. Did you get me? Tell him you move. Better quit beefing at this. In them dinner dip, I shoe you. On the head of Kubi, I go coo coo or boo boo like a shit beavers. I don't want to take a tip neither. The MCs, I'm the Grim Reaper. So anybody coming every trip like you're gonna run the wall with 10 Gizas. Whatever leak is pulling everybody call like I had a chip.
Hey everyone, I'm Megan O'Leary, and here's what you need to know for your UFC Minute.
If there was a hole in the fight game of this rising lightweight star, it was clearly in his stand-up attack. But this week, he announced that he was leaving his longtime team in order to join up with a new team that guarantees an intriguing new look that will result in plenty of knockout victories.
That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
Coming up next, a UFC lightweight division battle.
Bitch, I'm gonna land till I die. Till I die. On the east side till I die.
Well, this young man has run roughshod through the lightweight division. If he wins tonight, he will finally realize his first shot at that elusive UFC lightweight title. In this division, a title shot is so hard to come by. He has made his way to this title eliminator. He's the favorite tonight. We'll see if he can get this one out of the way. Next stop, a five-rounder for the UFC Lightweight Championship of the World.
This guy is an excellent striker. What he wants to do is utilize his footwork, his takedown defense, and land hard strikes to get the victory.
And now our tail of the tape for this lightweight scrap. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age, with some differences in height and a similar.
Ready to fight.
Fighting out of the southpaw stance. All right, so here we go, early round one. This is a number one contender's fight in the UFC lightweight division. If this man wins tonight, he has been guaranteed by UFC President Dana White a shot at the UFC lightweight title. You know how hard title shots are to come by at 155 pounds. He is one win away. He blocked the punch. Well, inside the octagon, he's one of the more watchable fighters on the roster, but his popularity has really started to soar. Recently did that photo shoot for UFC Magazine. Told me he didn't love the makeup, right? That was a little bit uncomfortable, but the photo shoot came out great and certainly is something that is gonna help him push his brand here moving forward. Hits home.
Oh! Huge uppercut misses.
How about that shin? Man, Joe, he continues to leave that head open. His opponent's got to be salivating at this point in time. That jab has been there all night. You got to get that head off the center line.
And there's a nice jab. Look at this. Beautiful kick there. Went for the head kick. Oh, very nice.
Clipped him with the right hand there.
Missed that shot. The kick lands. Hard right to the body.
Under 2 minutes in the first round. There's that kick. Able to land to the body there with the left kick.
Big punch.
Oh! Conor McGregor gets caught with that punch.
Huge left shot.
Hand. We'll see if he can follow it up. Under a minute to go in what has been a wild round one. right hand upstairs.
Really missed with that right hand. Oh, nice.
Inside leg kick is there by McGregor.
He's tagging him.
Sniff that one out as he blocks the kick.
Oh, man, with that right leg kick.
5 minutes in the books.
Here's a perfect kick to the body. Here's a nasty head kick that lands. And here's a perfectly placed kick that really does damage.
Brittany Palmer with us tonight.
You ready to fight? Ready.
All right, round two.
He's definitely going to want to start this round off fast to try to pick up where he left off. His opponent was in big trouble at the end of that round.
And he connects with the punch there. Well, Joey seems to have his opponent's timing down. He has landed some good shots, but nothing really in terms of multi-shot combinations, and perhaps that's why his opponent's still standing. So perhaps at this point, he could change up the power with which he throws some of these strikes, maybe alter the tempo a little bit, and try to make it so it's not just one and done when it comes to his striking attack. Punch coming, it's blocked.
Big kick, but miss. Look at this. Oh, my goodness. He tagged him. Landed a hard kick for the knockout.
Well, yeah, Joe, that fight was over as soon as that kick made contact. And with this particular striker, you are playing with poison if you don't get that guard up. You know these kicks are coming. You know they're coming in bunches. And that was a near-perfect land. Nailed the target. Full extension on the kick. And that's one of the better highlights we've seen here recently inside the Octagon.
And here we see it from a different angle. Look at the power in that kick. And as soon as it lands, that is the end. Look at this. And he's out.
So a seminal moment for him here tonight as he gets the huge knockout victory. That could hold up as one of the better knockouts of the year. Now we go inside the Octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 25 seconds of round number two. Declaring the winner by knockout, the Nightman.
So there's the man of the moment, just...
Jackson Franklin's. Got it.
DJ Khaled!
The DA on my way here. I made some millions on my way here. I seen you coming on my way here. I let my ass off on my way here. Benny Yaga with your brain bust open. That new Mustang got the brain bust open. Play them racks like Jimi Hendrix on a guitar. Load my gun, cock it back, and then I push start.
Like I ain't see him calling. Work so hard for man, I'm trying to get some free bands. I'm the king of the city, my house Graceland. No respect for rappers, they respect the coke man. That's why your favorite rapper acting like the dope man.
Survive, blame it on my soul, fire in the hole. angel on my shoulder, devil on my case. My anxiety, I can't escape. I feel alive, but something strange. I'm scarred for life, but where's the pain? Recognize your face, forgot your name. People come and go, that's a common thing. Playing the game, people will change. You think you know someone, they probably fake. People will lie, straight to
fighters fight for many different reasons. Some do it for the fame, others do it for the money. Eventually, all of that fades away. Yet going down in the history books as a UFC champion is something no one can ever take. It's proof that for a moment in time, out of all the fighters in your weight class, you were the best in the world. It's the culmination of all your hard work, the fulfillment of a dream. Tonight is your chance to take that gold belt and hear Bruce Buffer say, "And new." That kind of glory lasts forever.
Coming up next, a matchup for the UFC lightweight division title. Well, this man has compiled a serious win streak. He has paid his dues, and finally, after working his way up the ranks and taking on all comers, he has realized a title fight in this UFC lightweight division. You know how crowded it is at 155 pounds. You know how hard it is to stay on a winning streak in this division. He has done that. And now he is 25 minutes or fewer away from being forever branded a UFC lightweight champion of the world.
This is his first world championship fight, a real milestone, a real pressure situation for him. The amount of training and preparation that he has done over his entire life will culminate in this one evening. He is the number one contender to the title, and if he wins, he will...
Here he is, the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC lightweight champion of the world. Of course, the target is on his back. All eyes are on this man tonight as he tries to make good on yet another title defense. He has owned this division for some time. The question is, as the challenges get stiffer, can he remain the hunted? Several champions are till the tape for this, our main event of the evening. So more than 10 years apart, these two fighters. Some differences in height and reach. All right, now for the particulars, he is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City. It's time! Five rounds for the UFC Lightweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 17 wins, one loss. He stands 6'1" tall, weighing in at 150 pounds. Fighting out of Detroit, Michigan, USA, presenting the challenger, the Nightmare. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a grappler, holding a professional record of 31 wins, no losses. He stands 5'10" tall, weighing weighing in at 155 pounds, fighting out of the Republic of Dagestan, Russia, ladies and gentlemen, presenting the reigning, defending UFC lightweight champion of the world, Khabib the Eagle Nurmagomedov.
All right, this is for the championship. You've been giving your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
This has been one of the most highly anticipated matchups for a long time. And ladies and gentlemen, strap yourselves in, because it's about to go down right now.
Here we go. All right, so will we get a new champion here tonight? That remains to be seen. Round one is underway. This fight is a slam toe. And now is where things could get really interesting. Busy as he looks to improve position here.
Good shot to the head. Huge
he lands
left,
a big
hand.
Left hand there.
Excellent movement here on the ground. Back up.
That landed. Man, Joe, he continues to leave that head open. His opponent's got to be salivating at this point in time. That jab has been there all night. He's got to get that head off the center line. Effective punch there by Nurmagomedov.
And he's trapped in half guard here. Slides him over, and nice reversal here. Hip escape, gets out of the full mount.
Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up.
Good punch.
Double leg. Stuffed.
And back up again.
Inside leg kick is there by Nurmagomedov. Oh, he found the target there. That'll work.
Both men landing in that exchange.
1-2 punch by Nurmagomedov.
Nice kick to the body. Shin to the gut.
He's got him here.
The champ is rocked. He's in deep trouble. He's trying to hang on and keep his title. Excellent movement on the ground here. Constantly moving, constantly staying busy. Yeah, here he goes again.
Oh, and he's back up again.
Caught him with a punch.
That shot is blocked by Nurmagomedov. How about that shin?
Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy. Sticks to half guard now. Reversal and into half guard. Now into side control. Oh, elbow to the head.
Oh, he's back up again. You gotta like that. The horn sounds for the end of round one.
Trouble. There's no way he's gonna recover. I need you to get out there, and I want
you. Ready to fight? Ready.
All right, second round underway.
Starting off this round, you gotta think he's probably still hurt from that last round. He's gonna want to move and avoid taking damage early.
Nurmagomedov gets caught with that punch.
Good combination. Beautiful right hand.
Nice straight right lands. Kick to the body by Nurmagomedov. Oh!
And another one. He's in trouble.
Well, increasingly, you're seeing a lot of these American fighters go to train their wrestling at Crossbreed MMA. And in advance of this one, the coaches say he is in the best shape of his professional life. He trained hard, he trained smart, but they really feel like his takedown defense and his takedown offense have never been better. So let's see if that assessment results in a big win for him here tonight. Nurmagomedov gets in the clinch yet again. Let's see if he can get the offense going here. And again, Joe, he's showing a vulnerability to that jab, leaning right into his opponent's striking range and leaving his head wide open to absorb damage. Let's see if he can make some adjustments here.
Hard hook.
Well, he has landed some good shots tonight, Joe, but as yet, he has been unable to string together any solid combinations, and that has served to keep his opponent in this fight. So let's see if he can change up the tempo a little bit with his strikes and try to put together a combination that is more damaging to his opponent.
Stuffed it. Stuffed it. Again, he clinches here. Misses the takedown. Got him pressed up against the cage here. Almost hits him with that left hook.
So a much different approach from him here in round two. Took him a while to find the range, get in his striking rhythm. He has found it here, and as a result, has really picked up the pace in round two.
Nice.
Hand speed, man. Oh, nice job to get back up again. You don't want to hang out on the ground with this guy. Orthodox for much of the fight. He's going southpaw here, Joe. Shot just before the end of the round. So now he goes back to the stool, wobbly a little bit. We'll see if the corner can maximize these 60 seconds and keep his head in the fight.
And here's another devastating shot to the head. And you can see both fighters giving and taking in that round.
Listen, all right, hey, we all take shots, okay? All right.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Here we go, third round of this championship fight.
That one hurt.
Oh!
He got hurt very, very badly. This fight.
Oh!
He tagged him again. He's hurt. This could be it right here.
Oh, big left hook there.
Looks like he's got an anaconda choke. Beautiful job. Back up.
And both fighters exchange in the pocket. While he's playing with fire, Mitchell, he continues to be vulnerable to that jab by
Lowe. He's hurt here.
That knee might have landed there. Over under hooks here. Goes to the body there.
Here's a knee again.
Battling for hooks. And he lands the knee to the body now.
Jumped down for the guillotine. This could be it right here. He got it. Nicely done. He got the choke for the tap.
Well, yeah, Joe, you could tell he's been working on his submission game. That was really a choke that was set up perfectly. He got it sunk in deep, and his opponent was going to go to sleep if he didn't tap out, so he took the lesser of two evils, and he's forced to tap.
And here's the end of the fight. And here we can see it again. That's a real tight choke here.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 26 seconds of round number three, declaring the winner by tap out.
Well, there is a new king of the 155 pounders, and you are looking at him.
We gotta get it. They hated Esco. They hated Escobar. I'm still here. Davies, talk that talk. Streets need that.
And it's time for your UFC Minute. The MMA world is buzzing about that incredible performance this past weekend in the main event. Last weekend at Madison Square Garden in New York City, it was a night to remember for the mixed martial artist whose story has captured the imagination of fans around the globe as he fought the fight of his life when it mattered the most. When the dust settled, Bruce Buffer said, and knew. And he was crowned UFC lightweight champion of the world thanks to a memorable referee stoppage. That's it for today.
Stevie Wonder on the pianos. Geechee Liberace in the building. Ray Charles on the flute. Sway Wallabies, I follow policies. Always give a game every time she me. Shooting blanks, but you gotta hit the chart at least. Seen a lot of young MCs even die for peace. Posting pictures while I'm posted in Belize. Spent those lonely rainy nights just praying on my knees. Being overseas is a daily routine. Young traveling the world, that's just been in our genes. Put the gang together, now you traumatized. And Kofi's King Tut during Ramadan. Scramble like I'm number nine during the summertime. Double them back, number one and double back around. Drop DC 40 shots.